This video covers the operation and features found in the VLOG Pro 3, VLOG 3 XLF, and VLOG 3 ML receivers. For the most part, the features and functions of these receivers are the same. Where different, they will be noted. Supplied in the box are the following items: VLOG 3 receiver, mini USB cable, lithium ion battery, charger, AA alkaline batteries, alkaline battery holder, power cable for charger, user manual, soft kit carry bag. The VLOG 3 receivers can be used with alkaline or the lithium ion batteries. The central illuminated section within the battery icon indicates the amount of charge remaining. A blue center battery icon indicates the alkaline battery life status. A green center indicates rechargeable batteries. When batteries are low, the remaining charge section will turn red and will flash. To charge the lithium ion battery, connect the charger to the receiver's charging socket. The LED indicator on the charger will illuminate red until the batteries are fully charged. Once fully charged, the LED will change to green. The VLOG 3 keypad. The receiver has 6 buttons that serve different functions and help the user navigate the menu. The gray color keys also serve dual functions. This is an overview of the keys: on and off, reduce sensitivity, select frequency, increase sensitivity, enter key, information, and login screen. The receiver can be customized to suit the user's preference. The receiver has several features that can be switched on and off through the user menu. To enter the user menu, press and hold the I key. Release the key when in the menu. Note that where you see the enter symbol, pressing the enter push button gives access to the submenu associated with this button. To exit the menu or submenu, press the I button. Where the enter symbol is not shown, the enter button is used to scroll through the options of that feature. Use the plus and minus buttons to scroll up and down through the menu. In this example, we will enable our most used frequencies. Press the enter key to enter the frequency submenu. Scroll up and down the table of available frequencies using the plus and minus keys. Use the enter key to check the boxes on the right. Frequencies not checked will not appear on the locate screen. Warnings and alerts. The receiver will give the user feedback of warning symbols and accompanied by audible sounds and a vibration in the handle when the following situations arise. Signal overload is usually caused by operating too close to power transformers or being too close to a transmitter in induction mode. Moving away from that interfering signal will cure the problem. Shallow cable alerts indicate the locator has detected a possibly less than 6-inch deep utility. Proceed with caution. Swing alert indicates that the operator is swinging the locator excessively, which could result in misleading information. When sweeping the locator across the direction of the line, try to keep it vertical. This will improve its accuracy. Overhead cable. Alerts indicate that the source of the signal is mainly radiating from above. This alert is usually caused by the signal traveling along overhead cables. DFT feature. DFT is a tool to assist in choosing a frequency to apply to the target conductor. The DFT feature will aid the user with nearby interference that may affect the locate quality. Note, the DFT feature should not solely be used to determine which frequency to apply. Always follow the appropriate safety requirements mandated by safety legislation. safety practice, or your company's safety procedures when applying a transmitting frequency to a conductor. To perform a DFT assessment, verify any nearby transmitters are powered off to avoid additional signal frequency disturbance. Select your preferred frequencies from the frequency menu. These selected frequencies will be assessed in the next few steps. Navigate to the main menu and scroll until you see DFT. Select DFT by pressing the Enter key. Once the option is selected, the receiver will automatically assess the user's pre-selected frequencies. The receiver will scan all available frequencies and display a progress bar, and the list of frequencies assessed will be displayed. The frequency under test is shown on the top line. A numerical value ranging from 0 dB to 140 dB will be presented next to the frequency list, with 140 dB being the least possible interference detected, and 0 dB with the largest amount of possible interference. The results are ranked from the least interference possible at the top to the largest amount of possible interference at the bottom. The VLOG 3 series receivers give the user a choice of locating screens. The choice of the screen depends on the application and user preference. These screens are Classic Locate, Vector Locate, Plan View Locate, Transverse Locate. First, we will explain the functions of the Classic screen, as familiarity with this screen will help understand other functions. All VLOG 3 series screens have a status bar at the top, indicating various locator settings. Antenna configuration, continuous signal current and depth of the target line, transmitter link connection status, Bluetooth connection status, GPS status, speaker volume setting, battery type, and remaining charge. The Classic screen has all the functions normally seen on a classic cable locator, the main functions being percentage of signal strength that also mirrors the bar graph, signal direction forward-back arrows, this only activates with signal direction frequencies, peak level indicator, 360-degree compass line direction indicator that turns blue when aligned with the target line, gain setting, left-right direction to target line indicators, signal strength bar graph, distortion level indicator within the bar graph. Classic locating modes. The VLOG 3 series receivers have an array of 6 antennas, and these can be toggled through different configuration modes to provide different responses to the signals radiating from buried utilities. To do this, press the M key to switch between the following modes. Peak mode. Two horizontal antennas provide a peak, or maximum signal response over the buried line. This is an accurate locating method, as both horizontal antennas are used to provide a clearly identifiable peak. It is also less prone to the effects of signal distortion. The peak level indicator on the bar graph indicates the point of the largest signal detected, allowing the user to return to this point quickly. The compass line direction indicator aligns itself parallel to the cable, available in active modes. Broad peak mode. A single horizontal antenna provides a peak or maximum signal response over the buried line. The result is a less defined peak than the twin horizontal antenna peak mode. This mode is useful in deep lines because using a single antenna can boost the received signal. The compass line direction indicator aligns itself parallel to the cable, available in active modes. Null mode. The vertical null antennas receive a minimum or null response over the buried line. The null mode works well in uncongested areas, but is more prone to inaccuracies due to the effects of field distortion. This effect can be utilized to detect distorted fields by comparing the null mode position with the position of the peak mode. If the two positions do not coincide, this indicates possible distortion. The greater the difference, the greater the distortion. Left-right arrows indicate the direction to move the receiver to locate the buried line's position while in the null mode. Delta null. The delta mode uses dual vertical antennas. The delta null has the advantage that it provides a sharper response than the null mode and is less affected by distorted fields. All other functions are the same as the null mode. Delta mode uses dual null antennas to minimize the offset effects of field distortion. This mode tends to be more precise than the null mode. Peak with arrows. The peak with arrow mode operates in the same way as the peak mode. It gives the largest meter deflection when directly over the line. However, the left-right indication arrows are also displayed. The arrows indicate the direction to move the receiver to locate the position of the buried line. Omni-peak response mode. The two double-ended arrows around an icon mean that the line is detectable regardless of locator blade orientation. It is very useful for quickly checking an area for buried lines using a grid search, as one sweep will catch all locatable lines. In the classic screen, the Omni feature is available in the peak and broad peak modes. As previously mentioned, the VLOG 3 receivers have alternative locate screens. The following section describes the operation of these screens. To scroll through the available screens, use a long key press on the return key. The vector screen. The vector screen shows a cross-sectional view through the ground. A plan view is also shown to help orientate the user over the line. The vector screen is particularly useful where access directly over the line is not possible. The depth and horizontal displacement distances are shown, even when not directly over the line. Displayed are the following items: frequency selected, signal current, depth to the target line, horizontal distance to the target line, scaling that may be adjusted with plus and minus keys, plan view of the target, cross-section view that shows vectors to target. Using the vector screen, position the locator near the position of the target line. Use the plan view screen to help guide you towards the target line. You can imagine that the plan view is giving you a view under the ground. Position yourself so that the target line is pointing forward and back and is in the center of the screen. If the target is off the screen, an arrow will appear on the screen to help direct you to the target line. The lower section of the screen will respond as the target is approached. Use the plus and minus keys to alter the scaling if necessary to keep the dot in view. There is a black line leading from the locator icon to the target line. The dot represents the target. Around the dot is a circle. The size of the circle indicates a confidence factor. The larger the circle, the less confident the indicated position. Generally, the actual position of the line will be within the confidence circle. The color of the confidence circle also changes depending on the degree of confidence. Green, low distortion and high confidence. Blue, minor distortion in the magnetic field. Red, excessive distortion in the magnetic field. Notice that vertical and horizontal distances from the target line are displayed. This is useful when obstacles make it difficult to stand directly over the utility. The transverse plot screen. The transverse plot screen is used to analyze the magnetic field shape at a particular location, enabling the user to better feel for the data's reliability. Two plots are generated simultaneously: peak response, null response. In non-distorted fields, the peak and null positions should coincide, and the shape of the field should be symmetrical about the center line. To take a plot, first locate the target using one of the other locate screens. Position yourself to one side of the line such that the field markers are just on the screen. Clear the screen by pressing the minus button. Now walk across the target line at a steady pace until you are on the other side of the target line. Immediately press the plus button to save the plot on the screen. It is still possible to walk back over the target, locating the line's position and the transverse screen, while still retaining the save screen. The plan view screen. The plan view screen shows a picture as if you were viewing the line from above the ground. When the line is in the center and pointing forward and back, you are directly over the line and pointing in the line's direction. The following is displayed: depth and current readings, frequency selected, target line, lines of confidence, arrow indicates a direction to move towards the line. It only shows when the distance to the target line is far away. Using the plan view screen, position the locator within the approximate position of the target line. Use the plan view to help guide you towards the target line. Position yourself so that the target line is pointing forward and back and is centralized on the screen. The dotted lines on either side of the line indicate an area of confidence. The closer the dotted lines are together, the greater the confidence. In addition to the dotted lines, the color of the target line also changes depending on the degree of confidence. Green, low distortion and high confidence. Blue, minor distortion in the magnetic field. Red, excessive distortion in the magnetic field. If the target is off the screen, an arrow will appear on the screen to help direct you to the target line. Now let's walk through how to locate active signals using the classic perspective screen. Select a desired locate frequency matching the transmitter. Note, in the screen displays the compass or line direction indicator. In the presence of a locate signal, the compass will align itself parallel to the line being located. The compass helps to ensure that the operator is aware of the direction of the line. Hold the locator vertically and rotate it on its axis until the compass indicates forward and back. Adjust the sensitivity control so that the display indicates approximately 50%. Keeping the VLOG 3 receiver vertical, move to the side slightly. If the bar graph increases, you're moving towards the line. If it decreases, you're walking away from it. Move toward the line as indicated by the direction arrows until a maximum signal is achieved. It may be necessary to reduce the sensitivity to keep the bar graph on the scale. This is a normal occurrence and should be expected. Try to keep the VLOG 3 receiver vertical and avoid swinging it, as this may create false readings. Move the locator side to side to ensure a maximum signal is detected. Use the peak level indicator to assist. With the maximum signal found and the compass running forward and back, the VLOG 3 receiver is now directly over the line. If the signal is not distorted, the maximum signal's position will coincide with the same position indicated by the arrows. If these two positions do not agree, it may be because there is signal distortion. Continue to trace the line to its destination or source. When in a locate screen, a quick press of the iPush button will display the depth and signal current. The top left of the display shows longitude and latitude positional information. To the top right is the altitude above sea level. This information will only appear when the receiver is paired with a GPS module that is receiving a GPS lock. It is possible to take depth measurement estimations. To take a depth measurement, first pinpoint the position of the line. Place the VLOG 3 receiver's tip on the ground, making sure it is vertical and across the line. Momentarily press the I button. The screen will change to a screen similar to the one shown. The signal current value will also be displayed. This feature is useful for confirming that the detected signal is radiating from the correct line. If the signal is bleeding off onto other services, these signals will generally be less than that of the originating signal. However, care should be taken as the signal current will gradually reduce over the length of the line. When locating, always be aware that you are locating the signals radiating from the buried line. These radiated fields, as they are called, can be distorted by other lines or electromagnetic signals from buried lines or metallic features. The VLOG 3 series receivers can detect the presence of possible distortion. For example, the vector screen has a circle drawn around the target line, which increases in size and changes color in the presence of possible distortion. However, when using the traditional screen, the risk of an inaccurate location can be reduced further by the following. Check to see if other radiated fields are distorting the signal. Locate the cable first in the peak mode and then in the null mode. The two locations should indicate that the cable is in the same place. If they do not, the signal field is distorted, and the depth and current measurement may be inaccurate. In this example, we can see the bar graph is red, indicating some distortion. Also, the peak and null indicators do not match. Thank you for watching. If you have further questions or need technical support, visit our support page at vxmt.com or contact one of our corporate or local dealer offices found worldwide.